Last night on I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, our very own Sandra Sully dropped in to camp to visit the celebrities. Sandra delivering personal messages and all the latest news from home and abroad, and got the celebs up to date with all the news from around the world. With an emotional goodbye, another Celebrity Jungle's experience had to come to an end. And joining us now from the African jungle is Josh Gibson.
Hello, how are you?
Josh, we really thought you had it in you to possibly win the show. What was the most challenging part, do you think, of the whole experience for you?
It was Tash not voting enough for me. She wanted me to win it. No, look, it was definitely the lack of food. I don't know how much weight I've lost yet, but I've done a pre and post weigh-in, so I'm excited to see where how much I've lost and how much I'm allowed to eat to put back on, really.
Oh, you look totally shredded, mate. Now, you definitely weren't afraid to smuggle in some contraband. We saw you taking some lollies on night one. If you had your chance again, would you smuggle or be an honest man?
Yes, I was a big fan of the contraband. Unfortunately, I was the only one that did it, so it went pretty quickly. But I would definitely take in some spices for cooking. There's only so many ways you can do a soybean, and the one way is boring. So I would definitely be taking in something to put on meals because it is a long time. And choose your luxury item wisely.
Yeah. Josh, what is not boring is this rumour that has been swirling around Australia about a possible romance between you and Simone. Can you confirm, is it true, or is there even a chance that something might blossom in the future?
I can 100% confirm that there is no romance. Sorry, we're brother and sister. I get that you put two single people in the jungle, you had your Ron and Brenda, you had your 37-year-old marriage couple, you want some young spunk, but it wasn't us. We're just brothers and sisters. We're good friends. I'm sorry. I'm sorry if I've let you all down, but nothing there.
You took part in many tucker trials and you had to face your fear of heights. What was that like? Are you glad you did it?
Yeah, so it was day one and they thought, what better way to test Josh than give him his fear straight up? So I tried to keep on a game face. It was a shocking game face. I was as nervous as, but going backwards over that gorge at the start was really important for me. It just gave me a lot of confidence to know that I was going to be okay on this show and to have a go at my fears. So I'm really glad that I got to accomplish that and deal with some snakes and actually get bitten by a snake called Bernard, which was great.
Haven't we all? And Josh, you also participated in eating trials. Only a few days in, you had to eat an ostrich anus. I just don't. How did you do that?
Yes, the ostrich anus. It came out, they said it was for one star and it looked like bigger than any portion of meal I had in the camp. They told me just put the spoon in and I think like the, I don't know, some sort of rectum popped out and they said guzzle that down. It wasn't great. It wasn't fantastic either, but when you're in here, you've got to win stars, and I got to wash it down with some bull's testicles, so it was all good in the end.
Oh, no. Now, Josh, you were also given the challenge where you had to convince your campmates to blow a high-pitched leopard whistle to deter the animals from coming to the camp. Who do you think was the most gullible?
There was a few. Fiona was blowing that whistle like no tomorrow. It was hilarious that they didn't even look and see that the inside of the whistle had been taken out. The girls were pretty easy, especially Fee and Vicky. They were quite happy to walk around camp. Jackie, however, was very difficult and almost blew it at the end. I had to get slightly aggressive with her, so she gave it a rest and I got them a cake. And I got Vicky that comfortable Neil, the leopard that she cuddles every night. So all in all, it was good fun and a great little lie I had to tell.
Josh, who would you like to see win the actual competition?
I would definitely like to see Fiona or Pete win. I can't split them. I just think Fiona's been through so much. So brave of her to tell her story. She's hilarious. It would just be a great stepping stone for her career. And Pete's been the cornerstone, the backbone of our jungle crew. I just think he's another worthy winner. And I think from everything I'm hearing, I'm not hearing much news in here because we didn't get the news apart from Sandra coming in, but the whole Ron and Brenda's really kicking off and
As their adopted son, I'd like one of them to win.
Josh, we have loved watching you in the jungle. Thanks so much for joining us this morning on Studio 10.
Thanks so much. Look forward to coming home.
That's interesting because I still think, you know, Shannon Knoll, I think he will be really, really hard to beat.
Oh, forget about that. I think Josh and Simone. Josh and Simone, that's all I want.
It.
Josh and Simone, come on.
It's disappointing, isn't it, to hear him just go...
How could you not have a crack? I mean,
honestly, I would.
Yeah, I would too. He's beautiful.
I think Fiona should win.
Yeah.
She's great, isn't she? She's great. Well, don't forget to tune in to I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here tonight, 7:30 p.m. on both the 10 and Win networks. A Celebrity is leaving every night this week, so tune in. It is finals
week. More regular
week.
Than Sydney trains.
Yeah.